Good morning, everybody. Today's topic we have taken as COVID vaccines and variants. So far, we have come long way in this COVID, in the journey of this COVID pandemic, and it has affected badly. And the only hope is development of vaccines. But as everybody knows, this nature is much smarter and stronger than humans. And here, as vaccines are developed, this virus started mutating and forming many variants and kept on infecting humans. So still the war is going on, and we don't know when this will end. Okay. At this background, it is very interesting to know how these COVID vaccines are developed and what is its technology, what are its limitations, how these variants are formed, and what is the end solution of this pandemic. Okay, so let us start. So to know how the vaccine is working, we should first understand how the virus is working. Okay, so you know all that this is the basic structure of the virus, producing the spike-like antigen, spike-like structure on the surface. This is called as the spike protein. And it has many antigens on the structure. So, and what is antigen? Antigen is nothing but its identity. It's a genetic identity of that particular pathogen. So membrane antigen, envelope antigen are in the covering of this virus, and this is the nucleocapsid antigen present in the genome. Genome of the virus is the RNA single-stranded virus, and this is the spike protein antigen. This is the spike glycoprotein antigen. Just you remember this spike protein, which is mainly utilized in the formation of a vaccine. Okay. Now, how the virus infects the human? So once the virus enters into the human body, this spike protein attaches to the receptors on the human cells. When this attachment is done, this gets entry into the human cell. Okay, and then this hijacks this whole cellular, human cellular machinery to produce its own replica. And in with no time, millions of copies of this virus are produced, and they will come out of the cell and infect the adjacent cells. And thus, the infection spreads. Okay, so in whole of this process, if you can focus on this first initial step, attachment, this spike protein attachment to the receptor on the human cell. If this attachment is done, then further process, no one can hold on this further process, and the disease will be produced. But if this, we can block this, then there will be no further replication, and this is the step the scientists are targeting. So what scientists are targeting by development of vaccines? The vaccines work on this crucial step where this attachment of spike protein to the receptor is blocked, so that once there is no attachment, there is no further replication. Okay, so the vaccines work at this crucial step of attachment. These antibodies formed by the vaccines will attach, cover these spike proteins, so that there will be no contact of the spike protein and the receptors. Okay. Now, once here, as the virus is replicating, the body continues to defend immediately on the same side. So whenever our defense system is made up of all white blood cells. So whenever there is a virus, antivirus is entered, our white blood cells engulfs that, and it recognizes that this is the virus pathogen or the foreign pathogen. They will exhibit this on the surface, which is recognized by all immune cells of the body. Okay, so these are the T cells, helper T cells, B cells, and many more immune cells are recognized this as the foreign antigen, and they will start functioning. So the function of cytotoxic T cells is what? They will kill this infected cell so that the further multiplication of the virus is prevented. And what these B cells will do? They will produce these antibodies. And these antibodies, what they will do? They will cover this spike protein so that the attachment is prevented. Okay, so this is the normal immune response. And now, most important thing happens in this immune response is that some of the T cells and the B cells, they will be converted to the memory cells. Okay, memory T cells and memory B cells. What these memory T cells and B cells do, they will remember the structure of that spike antigen, so that whenever there is the further infection or reinfection, these memory cells will get activated and form the antibodies much instantly and much faster than the viral replication sets in, and they will destroy the virus. And hence there is no reinfection usually. And these memory cells stay in the body may be lifelong in many infections, but in COVID infections, we still don't know how long they will stay. So formation of memory cells is the basis for vaccine formation. Okay, so how these vaccines are developed? So suppose this is the virus, COVID virus, which is inactivated and which retains the antigenic property, will be inoculated in as a vaccine formation. And once this is injected into the human body will respond in the similar manner as a natural infection, and they will produce the memory cells. Once these memory cells are produced, they will remember the structure of that spike protein. Okay, so whenever the natural infection occurs, these memory cells are stimulated and they will evoke the same antibody response as a natural infection before replication sets in, and then they will destroy the virus and the infection is not exhibited as a disease. Okay, so this is the mechanism of the vaccines. Now, so far 180 vaccines, COVID vaccines, are developing worldwide, out of which only 20 vaccines are authorized by the national regulatory authority by many countries, and only 7 vaccines are authorized by the WHO. So these are the Pfizer BioNTech, Moderna, Oxford AstraZeneca, Covishield, Johnson & Johnson, Sinopharm, Sinovac and Sputnik. Now, depending upon how the vaccine is developed, what type of material, what type of technology is used for the formation of vaccine, there are 3 types of vaccines. Okay, so one is the vector-based vaccine, another is the inactivated virus technology, and third is the mRNA vaccine. So we will learn one by one. Before going to the virus technology, we will just revise the structure of the DNA and RNA. Okay, so DNA is double-stranded, RNA is a single-stranded. But what they contains? They contains multiple genes. Okay, and genes are nothing but the specific sequence of these bases to form a specific protein formation or specific structure or function of that virus. Okay, so if you consider this is as the COVID virus RNA, single-stranded RNA, if this is the COVID virus RNA, then this specific sequence, you consider that this sequence is coded for the spike protein formation. Okay, now this spike protein gene is studied by the scientists, that this specific sequence is for the spike protein. So they isolated this gene and they utilize this gene in the formation of vaccines. Okay, so you remember for the understanding that this specific sequence of the genes, which is called as the spike protein gene. So that spike protein gene is isolated by the scientists, and then they incorporated this gene into the genome of the adenovirus. Okay, now why this adenovirus is used? This adenovirus is used as just the vehicle to carry this gene. Okay, so this is vector. It is used as a vector. Vector means vehicle. Okay, it is just the transport medium. And this adenovirus is the simple cold producing virus in the humans as well as in the chimpanzees. So what happens when this is inoculated as a in form of a vaccine, then this gene will come into play and they will function, they will produce these spike proteins. And this will be recognized by our immune cells to form the antibodies and whole of the immune cells and finally form the memory cells. Once the memory cells are formed, then they will retain the memory of this spike antigen. Okay, so this is vector based vaccine. So vector here is the adenovirus, that is Covishield, Oxford, AstraZeneca, Sputnik and Johnson & Johnson. Then second is the inactivated vaccine. So inactivated vaccines are Covaxin, Sinopharm, Sinovac. What happens? This whole of the virus is utilized in this vaccine formation. Here what happened? Only that gene is utilized. Okay, specific gene was utilized. Here whole of the virus is utilized, but which is inactivated by the heat, radiation or chemicals, and then it is constituted to form the vaccine and which is injected into the human cells. And then they will, once it will be accepted as the natural infection, the body will respond as like natural infection to form these antibodies and formation of memory cells, as the same we discussed. Okay, so this is the inactivated vaccine type. The Covaxin is a type of inactivated vaccine. Third is the mRNA vaccine. These are the Pfizer, BioNTech and Moderna vaccines are based on mRNA technology. So what is mRNA? mRNA is nothing but the messenger RNA. The name itself suggests that it carries some message. So what message it carries? It carries the message of this sequence and this sequence for formation of the spike protein. Okay, so this sequence is this code language is this code is captured by this mRNA. mRNA formation is one of the intermediate step to form this protein formation. So if this is the spike protein to be formed, then this mRNA will carry the code language of this spike protein. Okay, and now this mRNA is utilized in the vaccine formation. So this mRNA is isolated into the laboratories and it is ensealed into the lipid nanoparticles. Just it is the covered, and then it is used to form the vaccines. Now once this is injected, this mRNA will start functioning. This will produce the spike protein. The spike protein will be exhibited on the surface, which will be recognized by our body immune cells, and they will form the antibodies and the memory cells. Okay, so in all these vaccines will work in what material is used. Okay, in vector based vaccine, this gene is used for the spike protein antigen. And a vector as adenovirus. Here the whole virus is used, which is inactivated, and here mRNA is used. Okay, so this is the regarding types. Now how the vaccines are developed? So vaccines usually develop in the four phases. We are seeing that this vaccine is in say stage one, this is in phase two. So what are the phases of the vaccine? This is the preclinical, which is experimented in animals first. Then phase one, 10 to 100 healthy individuals it is checked, and whether it is checked that the immune response is developing or not. Phase two is 100 to 500 targeted population, and phase three is 1000 to 10,000 targeted population. Okay, so how this vaccine trials are going on? Usual timeline is 10 to 15 years. From experimentation to total production of the vaccine. This is the simple chart regarding efficacy of the different vaccines and the dose intervals. This is Oxford AstraZeneca 62 to 90%, Pfizer BioNTech 95%, Moderna 95%, Covishield 70%, Covaxin 78%, and Sputnik 91%. And the doses is roughly from 3 weeks to 12 weeks usually. What are the common side effects of the vaccine? That is the headache, fatigue, muscle pain, joint pain, fever, the local site pain, local injection site pain are the common side effects. And the rarest side effects are the anaphylaxis, blood clotting, and the carditis. These are really rare complications that any vaccine may counter. So we should not, nobody should think of these rare side effects, because benefits always outweigh the side effects. Now coming to the variants, many variants have been evolved: alpha, beta, gamma, delta, delta plus, kappa, lambda, and so many will evolve still more. Okay, so just to brief it, alpha was originated from United Kingdom, then spread globally, beta from South Africa, gamma from Brazil, delta is the originated in the second wave of the India, in India. And now delta plus is also evolving. So these are the variants. Now, why these variants are formed? These are basically formed by the mutations. Okay, this is acts as a survival mechanism of any cell. It happens even in the humans also. Okay, so what are these mutations? Mutations are nothing but the it is a mistake in copying the DNA sequence during cell division. What happens in cell division? The cell organelle also gets exactly duplicated, and the nucleus also gets exactly duplicated. So nucleus means this DNAs are also from one DNA, the two daughter DNAs are formed, and the sequence of that basis is retained. But for some reason, this is the there is the mistake. There is the mistake of addition or deletion of one of the bases, and a new sequence is formed. Okay, so new sequence is formed, so new structure and new function of that protein is formed. Okay, so that is why the mutations are formed. Now the question has arisen that does these vaccines work against these variants? Are they effective against these variants? And why people are getting infected even after vaccination? Okay, so just to know the answers of these questions, we will just go shortly through this data studied by the ICMR. Okay, at 28th April. So in this data, if you see closely, that after first dose of so many Covaxin vaccine, only 0.04% have got infection have got infection. And only here again 0.04% after the receiving second dose of Covaxin. So the total percentage of getting infection after Covaxin is 0.04. And similarly with the Covishield, it is 0.02 and with the first dose and 0.03 with the second dose. Okay, so the overall infection rate after vaccination is not more than 0.02 to 0.04, which is a very acceptable limit for any vaccine to work. So this will not be considered as the vaccine failure. So still the vaccines are working against the variants. Now, what are the causes of the breakthrough cases? Breakthrough cases means those who have developed infection even after vaccination. So what are the causes? So first is the mutations, what we have studied. So the structure and function of the virus, it changed so that the body doesn't know how to defend, and hence it will cause the infection. Second is the old age. In old age, the immunity has been compromised. It is weak. It is not as strong as a standard. Then underlying chronic diseases also produces the compromised immune response. And lastly is the incomplete vaccination. For any vaccine to work, at least 2 weeks interval should go. Okay, so if any person has exposed to any person or to COVID infection before 2 weeks of vaccination or dose, then it may produce infection. So these are the causes that the breakthrough cases are happening. And how the vaccines are working against the variants. Okay, so vaccines are definitely not complete failure for the variants. They are still working. So what are the reasons behind this? Even variants are forming, but still the vaccines are working. So what is the basic science behind it? That the immunity, we are much focusing on the antibody mediated immunity. These vaccines mainly work against the antibody mediated immunity, but our human immune system is much complex and it involves many, many factors and many processes. So one of the another thing is cytotoxic T cells are working, dendritic cells are working. So many other components of immune system are working, even if that along with that vaccine mediated immunity. And then not every mutation expresses phenotypic change, means there are some point mutated, there are many non-significant mutations which may not exhibit phenotypic or structural and functional change. So it may not differ the immune response. And thirdly is the cross reaction of the antibodies. Means what? The antibodies which are formed against Delta virus may cross react with the Delta plus variant also. So there is the cross reaction probability of reaction of the antibodies. So these vaccines work against these variants, but definitely the effectiveness will be reduced. So what is the future scope of these vaccines is that it is the multivalent vaccines may come. Multivalent vaccines means which contains more than one variant into that vaccine. So they will contain alpha, delta, delta plus, all multivalent strains may be present in that vaccines. Or second possibility is the multiple boosters we have to take, maybe 6 monthly or yearly we have to take the boosters. Okay, now what is the end point of this? What is the end point of this pandemic? Okay, so herd immunity development is the only solution for end of this pandemic. And what is herd immunity? Means 70% of the population across the world should be immunized by the natural infection, either by natural infection or by the vaccination. So this is the only solution. So 70% of the world population. So this is possible only and only through the vaccination. We can't wait till the virus infects all 70% population naturally. Okay, so how this helps, if you consider this is as a herd, and this blue people are nothing but the vaccinated people. Okay, so they have developed immunity, and these red people are the still active cases. But now these still active cases are surrounded by all immune cases. The virus may not be transmitted to these new people, these vaccinated people, and hence these green people are secured. Okay, so if you consider this herd, 70% people are protected, then these 20-30% people are protected. So this is the mechanism of the herd immunity. And this herd immunity will be only developed by the mass vaccination. And till that, we have to prevent infection from social distancing and using masks, so that if the virus doesn't get place to enter and replicate, then it will reduce its virulence, and still slowly it becomes dormant, and still it slowly it becomes the like an endemic structure. Okay, so. So to develop that herd immunity, so far we have developed only 24.9% of the world population is vaccinated. So we have to go long way. And this is the only solution. And now just we are really waiting for this vaccine campaign to speed up and just finish this 70% of the population across the globe to get vaccinated and to end this pandemic, so that we will be free of mask and take a normal breath freely, happily. So just hope for the best. Thank you. Okay, for any queries, maybe we can take it personally or maybe when we can discuss it on the, when you come on the campus. Thank you.